Hello, I'm Mr. R. Mitcher, a retired lecturer in hermetology preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I want to stress, you know, that John the Baptist baptism has great importance, because this baptism shows you the way to the gate, which is narrow, that leads you to the salvation. Whereas the gate which is wide and open, which is of falsehood, which are sweeter than honey, which most people follow, that is in the opposite direction. And if you tread on that one, you are happily treading on that one. And those who go for the narrow gate, they are solitary. Because this knowledge received on individual basis. So you have to ask, seek and knock. When you start asking questions, first you may be asking silly questions, then slowly you start asking sensible questions, and you become then seeker. This narrow gate, you have to seek yourself. John the Baptist, put your face towards that narrow gate. And it's up to you to enter into that narrow gate by asking questions and becoming sensible. And when you become sensible, then you enter into the church, into that narrow gate, and then you start seeking his treasures. That leads to salvation. If you follow the other road, which is opposite in direction, the gates are wide, road is wide, then that is the road followed by the blind people, who just follow other people. Easy to do. Just follow what the other people are doing. And only blind follow others. Have you seen a man with the eyes open to follow anyone, another one? He goes by his own way. As the born blind person whose eyes Christ Jesus opened with spittle, John 9, after he teasing those rabbis and other things, he went of his own way. Christ Jesus was seeking him, but he could not find him because he had become an independent man, solitary. He had Christ in his heart. When you have Christ in your heart, you become solitary. If you have the book knowledge, then you are a Christian, dead Christian. That letters are dead. They are not living. Living is the spirit. And those, when you become living, the gospel sits in your heart and is no more in the book. What is written in the book, you don't go by that. You go by what your heart says, or what your logical reasoning say. Then you preach gospel with authority. So those people who do not take heed John's baptism, or do not understand John's baptism, they become tares, the sons of Satan. Satan catches them and he kills them. As they are being killed during these religious riots, as they were killed during these Holocaust, which they suffered in Britain, in Germany, and other countries, wherever they went, they suffered Holocaust. Only they did not suffer Holocaust was America. Because America does not belong to any tribe. It's a place where all sort of people live. All tribal people. No domination of any. Wherever there was domination, they were killed. So the America presented a haven for them, and that's why they prospered there to the great extent. So if you want to avoid sectarian riots and other things, then you become son of your tribal fathers. In the Brazilian jungle, where you call those people bush people, they have the tribal identity. They have tribal marks over their foreheads or over their cheeks. We lived in Ghana, West Africa. Over there, the people have tribal mark. Each tribe had its own mark. So by face, you can tell this man is a fra-fra-fra, this is Ashanti, this belongs to this tribe. So each tribe. I asked one of the students over there, why do you put these things? They say, you know, if we put these marks on the face, tribal mark, the person doesn't die. Same thing, the person doesn't get involved into the riots, religious riots, sectarian riots, because they will identify with each other that we belong to the same tribe. Why should we fight with each other? Whenever you lose your tribal identity under the religious color, as they are doing in Nigeria and other places, the people die. The greater the degree of cover, or the people cannot recognize each other. In Nigeria, people can recognize each other that we belong to the certain tribe, and then they stop. Where they cannot identify themselves, as in India, for example, there are no tribal marks on the peoples. People tell them, you know, that I belong to this tribe and that tribe. But during these riots, 1947 riots, many people died. But we were saved by our father, tribal father. About 2,000 people of the neighboring tribe, which is Arai tribe, they came to invade our village, attack our village. Before they wanted to attack our village, the headman of the gang, he said to the person who serves, manual person, we call him Marasi, mean who plays music and other thing, and who is always begging. He asked him, go and call the headman of the village to explain why he has got so many people in the village. When my father went to meet that man, unarmed, with his elder brother, and he explained to them that we tribal people, Jat, are going to die, and you are going to, or I'm going to die. A Sikh or a Muslim is a spiritual self, inwardly, not outwardly. And when it became clear to him, he told all those 2,000 people to look after us, not to give us any trouble, and they did look after us. So what I mean to say, that we became sons of man, and we made the other people sons of man. This planet Earth is for the living of the tribal people. If we were to be Sikh and they were to be Muslim, and the people who are living on this Earth planet, then we would have clashed and we could have killed each other. So that is natural, that nobody who is not remembering his tribal identity or forget it, he is to be killed. That's why Christ Jesus said, every plant which my heavenly Father did not plant, Heavenly Father is Yahweh, the creator of male and female, plant are the people, shall be uprooted by the roots. By the roots mean the supporters. So for greater details, you can watch my other videos. I put many on such topic, and you can make your own opinion. But God bless you. and preach gospel to your utmost.